Good morning, children. I am Ramya, your science teacher. Today again, I am back with another new topic. Machine. So what kind of functions it will be doing? That means in your earlier classes or in your lower classes you have studied like our body and its functions. That means different organ systems are working differently. So we call it as our total human body as a machine. So in the same way, here we are going to discuss about another new topic, musculoskeletal system. So this is a combination of two systems, musculoskeletal system, that means muscular system and the skeletal system. It is related to what? So if you are, before entering into the topic, like you touch your cheeks. First you touch your cheeks and your palm. So what you, how you are feeling? You are feeling it is very soft. Now touch your elbows, knees. So how you are feeling now? Somewhat hard. That means in our body, our body is made up of with flesh and some hard substances. That flesh is nothing but the muscles, and the hard substance which will while touching near elbows, and those are nothing but the bones. These two combination of the system we call it as a musculoskeletal system. So first we will be starting with the skeletal system. So skeletal system is nothing but the arrangement of bones from the top to bottom. From head to toe, the bones are present in our body. The arrangement of bones in our body from head region to toe region is nothing but the skeleton. We call it as a skeleton, and the study of this skeleton we call it as a skeletal system. The study of skeleton we call it as a skeletal system. That means how many bones are there, how they are arranged from the top to bottom, that we call it as a skeletal system. So why bones are necessary in our body, for what purpose? First of all, if you imagine once, without bones in our body, can we have any shape and structure to our body? No, there is. So the main function of the bone is shape. It will give shape and structure. Okay, it will be giving shape and structure to us. And more, what it will be giving? It will be allow us to do more work. It will be allow us to do different actions. Different actions like different exercises, like we are able to walk, move, jump, stand, bend, etc. So we are able to do these all functions because of the bones only. In this way, bones are very useful to us by giving the shape to our body. So generally, how many bones are present in our body? So in an adult human being, there are 206 bones. In adult human being, there are 206 bones, and a newborn baby, there are 300 bones. In newborn babies, in adults there are 206 bones, and in the newborn babies there are 300 bones. Later on, this number will be decreasing and converting into 206 bones. So how these 206 bones are arranged from the top to bottom, and what are the different types of bones are present in our body, and joints, and how they will be moving. Some are movable, some are immovable. Those all we are going to discuss in the skeletal system. Before that, I will be showing you the structure of a skeleton. You will be understanding very easily. Okay, here you can see the skeletal system. This is the skeletal system. In the same way, in our body also, bones are arranged from the head region to the toe region in this way. So if you observe, so here number of parts are there, number of bones names are there, but these all are you are not going to study in your class, but only as your lower classes you are studying only the few types of bones. So starting with the head region, here we call it as a cranium. In other words, we can call it as a skull also. The bones which are present in the head region, we call it as a skull. I am coming to the clavicle. This is a bone which is present in the shoulder region. Here if you observe, you can see here the bone which is present in the shoulder region, we call it as a clavicle. And next coming to the arm. Okay, next coming to the humerus, the upper arm. The bone which is present in the upper arm region, we call it as a humerus. And similarly, we have a thigh bone, right? In the leg region, the upper part is a thigh bone. The bone which is present in the thigh, we call it as a thigh bone, and that we call it as a femur. And this is the longest bone in our body. And next, coming to the chest region, this is the chest region in our body. And if you observe here, some ring-like bones, those are called as a ribs. And this is a vertebral column. It is not present in the chest region, but it is present backbone, that back side of our body, that we call it as a vertebral column. And also here you can see in the hip region, which is present below the rib cage, you can see the bones, that we call it as a pelvis. This is all about the few bones which are present in our body, and we will be detailed. I will be explaining about each and every bone in the classroom. Okay, so we have seen now different types of bones, how they are arranged and their names we have seen. So before, again I want to say about the functions of the bones. So how, what is the main function of the bones? As I said, that is functions of bones. They will give shape and structure to our body. Shape and structure to the body. They protect internal organs. They protect internal organs. Like, what are internal organs? Like the organs which are present inside our body, like brain, heart, lungs, liver, kidneys, etc. These all are protected by the bones only. And if simply bones are present, can our body move easily? No. Bones will be moving with the help of a muscles. Bones move with the help of muscles. With the help of muscles. So, these are the functions of the bones. And we have to keep on discussing about the bones. But what is bone made up of? What is bone made up of? Bone is made up of with a hard tissues. Bones are made up of with hard tissues. Okay? That is why it is very hard when we touch. And so it is made up of a hard tissue, and it is white in color. Bones are generally white in color, and what are the functions of the bones? They give shape and structure to the body. They protect internal organs, and bones move with the help of a muscles. These are the functions of the bones. And what are the bones present in our body? In a roughly like a skull bones. Okay. Next, coming to the rib cage, vertebral column, and pelvic bones, etc. Okay, arm bones, leg. bones, skull, rib cage, vertebral column, pelvic bones, etc. These are the bones which are present in our body. Not only these number of bones are present, but we will be discussing about these bones in our class today. So next, moving on to the starting with the skull, we'll be seeing how the bones are arranged and number of bones present in the skull region that we are going to discuss now. Okay. Okay. Here are the different types of bones: the skull bone, backbone or spine, rib cage, arm and the leg bones. These are we are going to discuss now in detail. First, coming to the skull bone. Now I shown in the chart, that is skull, cranium I said, that is nothing but the head region, the bones which are present in the head region. Okay, complete this head and face, we call it as a skull bones. Head and the bones which are present in the head and the face, we call it as a skull bones. And how many number of bones are present in this mesh? 22 bones are present. 22 bones are present, and 8 bones are seen in the head region. 8 bones in the head region and 14 bones in the face region. 8 bones in the 8 single bones are arranged in the head region, and in the face region 14 bones. Our face is made up of with 14 bones, and those bones we call it as a facial bones. Facial bones. And the head, the bones which are present in the head will be protecting what? I told you the functions of the bone, that bones will protect the internal organs. Now skull, what it will be protecting? It will be protecting the head. The bones which are present in the head region will be protecting the brain. It will be protecting the brain. And the facial bones will protect the organs like eyes, ears, nose and tongue. Okay, these are protected by the facial bones. This is about the skull. Next, moving on to the backbone or a spine. Now I'll say something to do, like bend. If you bend and you just touch your back, so something you will be touching, like a snake. The bones like a snake from the neck region to the down region. That is nothing but the backbone or a spine. Like it is present in the back region, it is present in the from the neck to the down. So the bones which are present, the how many number of bones it is made up of? It is made up of with 33 bones. But in this case, each bone is like small bones. The bones are arranged in a small bones. If you observe in this way, the bones are arranged in the backbone. And total how many bones? 33 bones are arranged one over the other and forms like a column. Now it is formed like a column, right? So as the bones are arranged one over the other, it is formed like a column, and we call it as a vertebral column. But vertebra, how the small bones, the bones which are present in the backbone is like one small bones. The each small bone we call it as a vertebrae. We call it as a vertebrae. And as the arrangement of bones are like a column, we call it as a vertebral column. Another name for backbone is backbone, spine, and also we call it as a vertebral column. And what it will be protecting? Well, backbone is protecting spinal cord. It will protect spinal cord. Spinal cord is nothing but the group of nerves running from the backbone. Group of nerves running from the backbone is nothing but the spinal cord. It is connected to the brain. Okay, it will be protecting by the vertebral column. We are able to bend. We are able to bend, move sideways. We are able to bend front, back, this side, that side. We can twist. All this we are able to do with the help of this vertebral column only. Just imagine if the vertebral column is made up of with a single bone. If the vertebral column is made up of with a single bone but not like a small bones, then can we able to move our body in a different angles? No. That means that is the reason why bones are arranged like small boxes or small bones one over the other. That is why we are able to bend in all the directions. This is about the backbone or spine, or another name is nothing but the vertebral column. 33 bones, each bone we call it as a vertebrae and protects the spinal cord. Next, moving on to the rib cage. The rib cage, the bones which are present in the chest region. In the chest region, the bones which are present, they will be like rings. The bones which are present in a rings like structure, like ring like bones, are arranged in the chest region are called as a rib cage. And the arrangement will be look like a, the arrangement will be like a cage. That is why we call it as a rib cage. And how many bones are present in this? There are 12 pairs of bones. 12 pairs of bones are present in the chest region. Those bones we call it as a rib bones. And as the arrangement is like a cage, that is why we call it as a rib cage. So as they are having the curved, like curved bones, as they are having, the two ends. As they are having the two ends, one of the end is attached to the vertebral column. One end is attached to the vertebral column and the other end is attached to the breast bone, which is present in between the chest region. Okay, here it is the chest region bone, breast bone, and back side is the vertebral column. One end is attached to the vertebral column and other end is attached to the chest breast bone. So in this way, 10 pairs out of 12 pairs, 10 pairs will be attaching to the both the ends, but two pairs of bones are freely attached only to the vertebral column but do not attach to the breast bone. They are present freely, and those bones we call it as a floating bones, which are present freely. Those are nothing but the floating bones. And what is this? And next, coming to the what internal organs are it will be protecting? That is that it will be protecting the heart and the lungs. This is about the rib cage. And next, coming to the arm and the leg bones. So we are having the fore limbs and the hind limbs, right? So hands and legs we are having, and it is divided into upper arm and the lower arm, and front we are having the fingers. So it is also having the bones. So this is the upper arm and this is the lower arm. Lower arm is made up of with two bones. And the upper arm is made up of with a single bone, and we call it as a humerus. So humerus, lower bones, two bones, and it is again attached with the finger bones. Okay, in the similar way, leg, this is the hand, arm bones, and this is the leg bones. Now this is the upper leg and the this is the lower leg. Similarly, here also lower leg is consisting of two bones, made up of two bones, again joined with the ankle, and again made up of with the toe bones. Okay, and the bone which is present in the thigh region, this is the thigh region. The bone we call it as a femur. It is of a single bone, and this is the longest bone in our body. And this is all about the arm and the leg bones. And one more bones, that is nothing but the pelvic bones. Those are present in the hip region. The bones which are present on either side of the hip region, we call it as a pelvic bones or a pelvic girdle. and this will be weight, the weight of a human body. Total our body weight is depend on this pelvic bones only, and it will be giving support to us while sitting or while getting up. We are able to these bones only will be helping us to move in the direction. So these are very important bones, and once if it is damaged, it's very difficult for us. So the bones which are present in the pelvic region are called as a girdle, pelvic bones or a pelvic girdle. Okay, next moving on to the different types of joints. Okay, next coming to the joints. What is a joint? First of all, what is a joint? For example, this is a chalk piece, right? This is a chalk piece. I made it into two pieces. So again, I want the same chalk piece as a big chalk piece. What is the necessary things I have to do for this? That means I should make a joint. That means I should join these two. I should put these two together. These two pieces, if I put together, it will become a joint. That means with the help of any plaster or any gum or whatever it may be, I will be making it as again the big chalk piece. So similarly, in our body also, bones are joined together. That means the place where two bones meet. The place where two bones meet, that point we call it as a joint. That point we call it as a joint. So now I attach to these two chalk pieces together with the help of a plaster or any other thing. In the similar way, two bones also should be attached with the some or the other substance. That is nothing but the ligaments. Two bones are joined together with the help of a strong tissues are nothing but the ligaments. With the help of ligaments only, two bones are joined together. Now I will ask you, like, where are the joints you can see in our body, in which regions? Like, first one is elbow region, in the knee region, in the neck region, shoulder region. Okay, wherever we are able to move our body parts freely, those places we call it as a joints. And the place where two bones meet is nothing but the joint. And with the help of what they are joined together? With the help of ligaments. Again, the joints are divided into two types. Joints are divided into two types, that is a movable and the immovable. Movable and immovable. Movable joint, that means here we are able to move our joints freely. So immovable means even though there are joints in that bones, but they are unable to move. What are those? That will be seen now. First, coming to the movable joints. The movable joints are again classified into four types, like hinge joint, ball and socket joint, pivot joint, and the gliding joint. So first one is a hinge joint. Carefully, if you observe, I stretched my arm. I'm just bending my lower arm. I'm just bending my lower arm to my shoulder. Again, I get back to my original position. So I'm freely able to move from there to here. Right? Now, can you bend similarly in the opposite direction, in the backward direction? How I am moving in the upside direction, can you move this joint in the, can you move this arm, lower arm in the backward direction? No, we are unable to move our joint in the different directions. The joint which help us to move the body parts in only one direction, which help us to move in only one direction, is nothing but the hinge joint. Further, I will give you the best example. Like in your house, you are having the doors, right? If you want to open or close the door, it will be opening in only one direction, right? Either it will be going inside or it will be coming outside, but not both the sides your door will be working. In here also, similarly, the bone will be the joint which is helping the bones to move only in one direction. I am able to move my arm only in this direction, but not in this direction, right? That is why that type of joint we call it as a hinge joint. So where, which kind of places we can see the hinge joint? In the elbow region and in the knee region. In the elbows, in the elbow and knee region. Elbow and the knee regions we can see the hinge joint. And next coming to the ball and socket joint. Ball and socket joint. So how, why the name it came as a ball and socket joint? So for example, the bone, one end of the bone will be like ball, and other end of the ball, bone will be like socket. One end of the bone will be like bone, and other end of the bone will be like socket. For example, one end of the bone is like ball, and other end of the bone is like socket. And these two bones are joined together to make a strong bone, and that bone type of bones we call it as a joint. We call it as a ball and socket joint. One end of the bone is like socket, and other end of the bone is like what? Ball. So once if these two are joined like this, they form a ball and socket joint. So in this type of joints, the body parts will be moving freely in all directions. In all directions. For example, where you can see this ball and socket joint? In the shoulder region. We can see in the shoulder region, and also in the pelvic region, like hip bones also you can see the same ball and socket joint. Here hip bones are also made up of with a ball and socket joints. For example, if you see, I am able to rotate my hand, complete hand, so I can bend up, down, back, front, so even I can rotate. That means the joint which helps the bones to move freely in all directions is nothing but the ball and socket joint. Next, coming to the pivot joint. Pivot joint is present in the neck region. Here in the neck region, you can see in this portion only, we can see the pivot joint. That means above the vertebral column and below the head region, we can see in the neck region. We can see this kind of joint in the neck region, exactly above the vertebral column, you can see the pivot joint. So what is how it will be moved? We are able to move our head like up, down, okay, down, up, sideways. We are able to rotate our neck in all the directions because of this pivotal joint. Next, coming to the gliding joint. Where this gliding joint is present? This gliding joint is present in the wrist region. It is present in the wrist region and also in the ankles. Wrist, ankle also we can see this kind of joints, and even in the fingers also. Okay, we can able to move like a bend, but we are unable to move it back. So this gliding joint is present in the wrist and ankle region and also in the fingers. This is all about the movable joints. Next, coming to the immovable joints. Immovable joints, like I told about the skull bones. The bones which are present in the head region are nothing but the skull bones, right? Skull bones. Have you observed any time our head, the bones which are present in the head region moving? So now I am talking, but only my lower jaw is moving, but not the head region. Until unless total I will move my head, I am able to move my head in different directions, but not the bones in the head region are moving, but only the lower jaw in our face it is moving. And out of all the bones in the complete skull region, only the lower jaw will be moving. Lower jaw only the movable joint, and the remaining all bones which are present in the head region, in the skull region, will be immovable. Even though they are having the joints, but they are unable to move. If you want, you can try like moving your eyes. You are able to move the eyes and or like muscles, but not the bones which are present in this head region. This is all about the joints and the type of joints. Next, moving on to the muscles. Okay, we have discussed about the skeletal system, right? So that is about now this is a worksheet regarding the skeletal system. So first question is, write one function of the following. Write one function of the following. First one is skull. Write its function, like what it will be protecting in that way. And next, backbone, ribcage and the girdle. Okay, for this you have to write one function. And the next question is, what is a joint? Write the types of joints you have studied. So first of all, write the definition of the joint. That means what is a joint? And also write which makes two bones to join together. That one thing is there to join two bones. Write that also in this question. And next, write the functions of the bones. Write few functions. I told in the beginning of the class about the functions of the bones. So you have to write the functions of the bones. So what are they like? They are giving shape and structure to the body. Okay, and they help in different movements. Like that, what I told in the class, that you have to write. If you follow the class properly, you can easily solve this worksheet. And I will be coming with the next video regarding the muscular system, like part 2 of this topic, muscular system will be coming in the next video. Okay, till that time solve the worksheet. All the best.